All right, guys, I'm going to talk to you about my time with 13 Market Moves and the ups and the downs, and actually the importance of choosing the right broker to trade with and the issues and the struggles that we ran into in using Webull, as a matter of fact. Some of the problems that we ran into that potentially stopped me from getting where we should have gotten to a little bit sooner. We did have some issues. I don't think it would have stopped us so much, but it could have grown the account a lot quicker, I think. So starting back, you know, the journey began back in, if I'm not mistaken, it was August. I did the free week, you know, with the coach, that they were advertising at the time. I had $4,000 in a Webull cash account. Not a margin account, so wasn't worried about day trades, but you have to worry about your buying power, etc. Took the $4,000, doubled it like within the first day or two, and then just everything just kept going the wrong way for us and ended up with pretty much $0 in that account at the end of the week. So the only thing I saw was just I lost $4,000, $4,000. I'm done, you know. Went back to trading in my own account for a little while. I had more than $4,000, of course, to trade with at the time, but that was all I was really willing to risk, because I didn't know. And so went back to trading my own account. It was pretty much a one for one all the time, you know, win a few hundred here, lose a few hundred there, very flat. My large account, my long-term account, I mean, it goes up, but you know, it's very slow. It's very molasses. Positions are all over the place. But my day trade account, you know, that I had in Webull, would stay around the $30,000 mark, between $30,000 and $25,000. So I'd always be able to day trade, but I'd go up to 30 and then come back down to 25 and then go up to 30, you know, maybe go to 33, pull some out and then go back down. And it was just a nightmare. And then we moved on. So the, what got me back to trading with Leo was I had a trade I took, on spy puts, bought like $1,000 worth of contracts and just knew it was gut feeling, looking at the chart, saw resistance, things like that. Just had a really good idea it was coming down at the end of the day. So of course I bought a position with Webull. You have to buy before 2 p.m. Eastern. You can't buy 0 days to expiration options past 2 p.m. Eastern on Webull, if you didn't know. So I bought my position like right at 159 Eastern. So of course, sat there and watched it. Of course, market kept going up a little bit more. And then when it started coming down, I was able to hold on. And I think I closed out about 150% profit on it. So my $1,000 was like $2,500 worth of contracts I sold. And was actually really happy about it. Thought I'd made a really good trade, which, I mean, not bad. 150% is okay. And then either later that night or the following day, is when I saw Leo posted a video. Exact same trade I took. He bought better strike prices that actually grew larger than mine did. And he actually bought into his trade later than I did, but held through it and held it like to the bottom. He's got a video. I was like 5K to 45K or something like that. You can go back and look at it. I took that exact trade, but about the time he was getting in is when I was getting out almost. Just a little bit after he got in is when I got out of that trade. Nobody was there to tell me, hold it, you know, it's going to keep tanking. And plus I was so gun shy and so fearful that I see green and it's like, oh, I got to take it. I got to get it out of here. But yet at the same time, I would sit there and look at a red trade and go, oh, it's going to come back. It's going to come back. It's going to come back. And it just keeps going down. So I saw that video and I thought, you know, I need to give them another shot. So I got back in contact with them, had $25,000 in my Webull account. And it started, and I want to say it was up until It was around the beginning of November we started. We had some good trades, had some bad trades, ended up losing some money. But here's the kicker. Weeble, when we got below 25 at the close of this day, would flag me with a PDT rule. But yet the very next day, when those same positions would take us over 25 grand, I would close positions, but I'd have no buying power available because of the day trade issue from the day before. Even though we were back over the $25,000 mark, my buying power was unavailable to go into new positions or add to positions. So there were sometimes I do believe that we missed out on stuff. There was a UPST trade they did that was like a 4X trade because it was just rocketing up, but I had no buying power. I couldn't get into any of those positions, even though I was pretty much cashed out of all positions at the point, except for one or two. Therefore, I missed out on who knows how much on that UPST trade. And that was back in early November. Moving on through November, you know, November 10th, like, I've got a day where I've got 32 grand in the account, but it still got me flagged. Can't buy anything, you know, like that was the day with UPST. So we moved over to TD Ameritrade. I moved some money from my big account into a cash account, created a separate account in TD Ameritrade, started using that one, started at 25 grand in there. Kind of finished some issues in Weeble and stuff, ended up with only $7,000 left in Weeble. So I started at 25 grand in that account, was down to seven. That was the beginning of it. But I still believed that he was gonna get me across the finish line. So we added the money into TD Ameritrade and started going from there. And so, and this is also after in Weeble, I had added money into Weeble a couple times, 4,000 here, 7,000, you know, to get us back to that over 25 grand to get us above PDT, but yet it did never really work out right. So we missed out on some profits in there, but you know, it is what it is. So, we moved to TD Ameritrade and started using cash account. With the cash account, the way they work settled funds was different than Weeble. So I wasn't able to direct how the trades, when we were cutting a trade or taking profit or something like that, based on where the settled funds were going to line up. If we were going to close it and I'd have no funds, we might hold it to get more profit if we didn't have those settled funds to go into another trade. So we had a couple days of figuring that out. And then eventually I just said, you know, to heck with it. I opened up my margin account. I just moved all my money out of the margin account and moved all my positions out of the margin account into my cash account and left 25 grand in the margin account or whatever it was we had at the time. So that brings us to last week. He told me to get an interactive brokers account, which I did, funded it with $5,000. He wanted me to be able to get into like gold futures, things like that, which would make killer money on that. And that was beginning of last week. That money was available and we could start using it. Moving into this week, it was, if I'm not mistaken, Monday. Monday was the day. So Monday was the day that I'll probably regret for a long time. I'm trying to get to Monday on my phone and see exactly when it was that we were doing this. Because, yeah, yes. There it is. So this was November 22nd. So on Monday, we got in and we were in ES puts, Tesla puts. We had some Roblox, did some work with NVIDIA. And he meant for me to buy ES and Interactive, which I ended up doing. Sold half of my gold. We had gold puts. And at this point, my 5K account in Interactive Brokers by Monday was sitting at about $20,000. So we had 4X'd that, and that was pretty much just with gold futures. And I think Rivian puts the last week we did Rivian puts, and I think we did it in that account as well as TD. But we had gotten it up to 20K, so it was doing really good. We got some GME calls and then we cut it, and got out of it. And this, at 8:41, my 25K, we were at $63,000, on Monday. And then we closed all the gold contracts, closed the NVIDIA, closed the GME, counts at like 55K. And we had dropped the, Interactive Brokers account down to 12K. Closed Roblox, then we count to 56,000 and 10,000. And so then we start, got Interactive Brokers down to 6.6. This is at 9 o'clock in the morning. So 20 grand to 6.6 in a very short time. I'm sweating bullets over here. We're just losing money. At least I'm feeling it. And then we're getting into some other positions, getting everything going. I'm trying to get to the point here. And here we go. Rivian puts, SPY puts, Tesla puts, ES puts even that I still had. Here we go. Counts at 70 grand in TD, 12K in Interactive Brokers. We're buying and selling still 70 grand, 73 grand, 78 grand. And we're just popping 21 grand in Interactive Brokers, getting back up there. And then, you know, one screenshot, and I'm sure Leo's got it. Hopefully he'll put it with this video. At about 11:03 a.m., my TD Ameritrade account was at $181,000. So what am I thinking? We need to sell. Oh my God, let's sell. Let's get out of this. Let's close these positions. This is more money than I've seen in I don't know how long. Interactive Brokers was at $71,000. I'm like, oh my God. So we keep going. And this is when the day turns. So 180,000 is now at 122,000 by 11:45. And 129 by 11:52. Interactive Brokers, though, is up to 86K. We were had gold puts, and that was still going down, so that was still working for us. And then we're at 109,000. And then we're, at 92,000. We're at 87. And I am just telling him, I'm keep waiting. It just keeps going higher. How does the action on the SPY not look bullish to you? Since lunch, it's been higher lows and higher highs. And I'm telling him, I'm about to start selling. It's back over VWAP and grinding higher. And he's telling me we can get a sharp drop any moment. Wait. He said, as long as the dollar keeps setting daily highs, you want to stay short the market. They are not done selling. I'm not believing it because it's just going up. My profit's completely disappearing. Down to 74,000, down to 65,000, 61,000. Here we are at 55,000, and now I'm freaking out. Like, we've just lost everything we built today. You know, I can't believe that we're where we are. And I'm just posting pictures of this, and I'm being incessant. I'm crying like a little girl about my money, and where is it going? I can't believe it's gone. Mind you, I was at $180,000, and now I'm at 55. I mean, we've lost $130,000 practically, just holding on to these positions. And I'm thinking, why didn't we sell at 180 and wait for the market to go up, and then we could get back in, and we could have made more money, or, you know, something, anything, you know, but I'm freaking out, not realizing that he doesn't want to get out of the position because he's waiting for the actual move he was anticipating. He's told me before, we trade the charts, not the profit and loss. Like, you don't need to look. You should just look at the chart and wait for it to go where you want it, and then look at your positions, start closing them, see which profit and loss was at the end of the day. So at one point, he pretty much just told me, sell all, fuck it. That was it. Just fuck it, get out. Because I was pestering him so much, constantly sending him pictures of where my profit and loss was and where I was sitting and everything, just horrible. And then finally, he says, sell all, fuck it. Watch it drop as soon as you do. And I said, man, I'll hold. We've made more than enough in Interactive Brokers to cover it, but damn. He said, no, just sell both accounts, everything. Fuck it. You had a chance to make 600K today. So I told him, you know, all right, so sold it all. But anyway, as we continued on with the day, if you go back and look at what happened to SPY on Monday and Tesla and everything else, I went back and looked at what the contracts would have been worth at the end of the day, like just a couple minutes before. I screenshotted it, and then I added how many contracts I had of every single bit of that position, and then I ran the numbers. I would have had well over $300,000 in that account. All I had to do was quit being a little girl and listen to the man and let the trades play out. Not worry about the profit and loss, not sit there and cry about how it's going against me, I just needed to pay attention and let the trade play out. Listen to the man that's been doing this for a long time and let it play out. We've had some real big winners and we've done well. And so I don't, you know, I'm so attached to that amount of money. I mean, $181,000, I don't make that in a year working my job at all, you know? And so when we moved up, and of course he was nice enough to send me screenshots of some of the other members that did stay in the trade and made huge, huge gains, which I'm sure he can show you those pictures right now. That day was a big day and I couldn't believe it. So we started out the very next day. Now I still had $77,000 in Interactive Brokers. Let's keep in mind that account went from 5K and we started off the very next day at $77,000. So that account was still up huge and I've still got, I think the start of the day I had $45,000 in TD Ameritrade when we started the next day on Tuesday. And so we started getting into a lot of different stuff. And needless to say, at the end of the day, yesterday, we ended the day with the Interactive Brokers account at, gosh, I want to say just a little under $120,000. And TD Ameritrade account was at $77,000 at the end of the day. So he was still able to easily take and run, the accounts up and get us really, really good positions, and get us really good money. Needless to say, at the end of the day, from about November 1st is when we started trading, with Leo, and I'm probably one of his light cases. Like all I had to do was pay attention. We would have had 300 grand at the end of Monday. And if we would have made the same kind of moves that we did on Tuesday, the same, just with more money, my gosh, I'd probably be sitting on $500,000 right now. But it comes down to the fact that I would not listen, or I was listening, but I was trying to force him to tell me to sell it. I didn't want to sell on my own. And I just really wanted somebody else to blame, I think, for why I'd lost money. It couldn't have been my fault. Well, this time it was my fault. The pestering, the hounding, the bugging him. I do the same thing to people all the time. If you keep bugging me about something, I'll just say, fuck it. Do it. Do whatever you want. I don't care. You know, even if it's going to cause you harm or whatever, it doesn't matter. There's a certain point where I'm done holding your hand. And that's pretty much where he got to me, or got with me, causing the issue we had. But at the end of the day, we ended up about $100,000 on the month. So to go from a $25,000 Webull account to two accounts, one with $77,000 in it and the other with about $120,000 in it. And then you subtract some of the money I added and everything. It still comes out to where we were up about $100,000, on the month. And guess what? I don't make that in a year at work. So, $100,000 in a month. I'm ecstatic with the gang we got. And I'm actually super excited about the future, and what we're going to do next week. Maybe what we're going to do this Friday after Thanksgiving or Monday of next. Just the next time he calls a play and tells me, go in, guess what? I'm going to sit down, shut up, and close my mouth. I'm going to learn everything I can, ask questions about why he did what he did. I need to be able to find these things on my own one day. But for the time being, I'm done asking. And you can even ask. He can show you on Tuesday. After I saw what I did on Monday, Tuesday, it was just, I'm not going to sell until you tell me. He never heard me say, hey, everything's going down. Should I start selling? I need to start selling. I didn't cry nothing. I waited for him to tell me. And he told us when to get out of positions. He saw things in the market. Granted, I saw we could have made a lot more money on Tesla puts, but it wasn't looking right to him. And I get it. It didn't look good, but, looked like the market was reversing and we didn't want to stick around for that. So we left some money on the table, but still bonus up. All I got to say is if you're thinking about doing it, don't use Webull. Can't stand them now. Get with TD Ameritrade or something. Set a margin account with them. They have cash accounts too. They're not going to screw you over. Webull was just, we could have grown so much quicker and so much better if not for Webull. I know that was a huge impact in the beginning of the month. There was a lot of outlying factors this month that really stopped us from making some of the gains we should have, and kind of held us back. And then, like I say, the big winter day is where I held us back. And so, thanks to Leo, huge help. I really appreciate it. And like I say, if you're thinking about doing it, man, jump in. Do what you got to do. Get some money in an account. Start trading. Let these guys lead you. Let them direct you. You'll be amazed at where they can take you, and the profits that are available. If you're trading, you're doing that I make a couple hundred here, but lose a couple hundred there. And, you know, you're just him hawing around, get with them, and put your emotions in check, set them to the side, forget they exist. Put the money in the account and just know that it's money. It can come and go. You're going to have some bad weeks. He's going to lose money. He's going to put you in trades. And they're just going to go down and fall. And you're just going to be like, why the hell did we even get in this trade? Well, he saw something that we don't. And there's a reason he got in it. But I tell you what, if you put 10 grand into 10 trades and 7 of those trades failed and you lost 70 grand, but 3 of them, they 10X'd and you made 300 grand, you're still up $230,000. So, you know, you're going to have to take his losing trades because he's seeing what he's seeing and he's got the position. He's getting you into it. But like I said, there's going to be a few of those that are just going to be grand slam, out of the park, over the lake kind of winners. The other ones are going to be fouls and, you know, base hits and strikeouts. But if you stick with him and follow with it and hold on, he's going to show you the profit. It'll come through. It's good stuff. Like I say, can't recommend 13 Market Moves enough. They, like I said, if you make 100 grand, I mean, They led me down that road. I wouldn't have made 100 grand by myself. I wouldn't have been able to bring myself to put that much money into a trade without somebody really behind me pushing me to get in there and get it done. Put the money in there, buy it, buy more. And when you see a 100%, 200% return and you put 20 grand in there, like, you know, that's something I'd never be able to sit there and sweat it out and believe in myself enough to get it done. Having the coaches there with you, behind you, helping push you, huge help. Like I say, I'm definitely a believer in Leo and the coach team there. So 13 Market Moves, get with it.
Trading wins and losses is just like everything else in life that is worth fighting for. You remember your marriage? Man, it was beautiful when you were getting married, but you had no idea how ugly the losses of this divorce were actually going to be. Like opening a business, thinking you'd get rich overnight. But in the midst of it, you ended up maxing all of your credit cards just to sustain that business for a few years before you even realize a tiny bit of your first profits. Like buying a house thinking it would go up in value forever and ever, just realizing how wrong you actually were when 2008 hit. Like having kids, it was such a great idea at first. Remember how excited you were, terrified and scared at the same time, how much joy you actually had. Until your kids turned 2. Man, the terrible 2s. You thought that was bad. Until they turned 13, 14, 15. Shit. But you wouldn't change it for anything. You love your kids, no matter what your emotional losses or wins are with them, no matter what your financial losses or wins are. It really doesn't matter, does it? You don't quit on your kids, no matter how tough things actually get. For some of us, it's the same thing with trading. Just think, how long are your kids going to be your kids? The answer answer is forever. How long do you see yourself trading the markets? If your answer is forever, then you owe it to yourself and your kids to invest in the 13 market moves formula, so that your life journey of trading would be most rewarding and joyful, both financially and emotionally. Live to trade, trade to live. Conquer the world one trade at a time, fearlessly using the 13 market moves formula today.